Many people have the misconception that opening the secondary throttle plates sooner will provide increased performance and quicker drag strip times. Others think they must feel a kick when the secondaries engage. Still others believe that they should disconnect the vacuum diaphragm and make the secondaries open mechanically. Let's discuss these points in a reverse order.
First, you should never attempt to convert a vacuum secondary carburetor to a mechanical carburetor. There's no accelerator pump on the secondary side of the bowls or base plate to support this change. All mechanical secondary carburetors utilize a pump shot to prevent bogging when the secondaries are opened. Secondly, vacuum-operated secondaries will not offer a kick that's commonly associated with a mechanical secondary carburetor. In reality, you should feel a mild transition as the secondaries begin to open. And third, the secondaries must not open until the engine requires the additional air. This allows torque to increase along the peak torque curve. Performance is actually compromised less by holding the secondaries closed a little longer than by opening them a little too soon. Also, if the vacuum secondaries open too fast, it'll result in a backfire. The air cleaner configuration and restriction plays an important part in spring selection as well, so make sure to use your air cleaner when you're evaluating your vehicle's performance after each change. Don't expect that you can wing the throttle and see the secondaries begin to open. If they do, they're most likely opening too soon. Secondaries should only open when the engine's under a load. The opening rate of a vacuum secondary system is controlled by the diaphragm spring located in the vacuum secondary diaphragm housing. A lighter spring will allow the secondary throttle plates to open more quickly when compared to a heavier spring. A spring assortment kit, Holley part number 20-13, is available to help you customize the secondary opening rate to your application. A very helpful upgrade part is the quick change kit, Holley part number 20-59. It consists of a two-piece secondary diaphragm housing cover, which, after it's installed, can easily cut in half the time required to change the secondary spring. When making changes, do not clip a spring in an effort to make a spring lighter so that the secondaries will open sooner. Strange as it may seem, clipping springs shorter increases the spring rate and will actually delay the secondary's opening. Changing the secondary spring should never be done unless the accelerator pump nozzle system has been completely tuned first. Heavier vehicles with small engines will require a relatively stiff spring to prevent the secondaries from opening too soon and causing a stumble. Lighter cars with larger engines will tolerate a much lighter spring because RPM increases more rapidly. To tune the vacuum secondaries, you'll need to change the internal spring to a different tension rating. If you like, you can click now to see details on how to switch springs in the standard type vacuum unit housing. Models with the quick change unit will be much easier to change springs. There's no need to remove the entire vacuum unit during reassembly, and the diaphragm won't need to be refit to the vacuum unit when it's put together. With the quick change unit, two screws are pulled, the spring is swapped on the cap, and then the cap and screws are replaced. This change can be done very quickly with the carburetor installed in your vehicle. When tuning the secondary spring, all testing should be done in high gear to maximize engine load. If there's no stumble in the high gears, there won't be any in the lower gears. You'll want to go through careful trial and error testing over a measured distance of acceleration so you can determine which spring will provide the optimum opening time. The best situation to use is the lightest spring possible that will allow the secondary actuation without causing an engine stumble. A good way to verify if the secondaries are even opening is to attach a paper clip to the vacuum secondary diaphragm rod, push it up against the vacuum diaphragm housing, and take the car for a drive. If the secondaries are opening, the paper clip will be pushed down away from the housing when you check it. If not, try swapping to a lighter spring.